I'm going to say something controversial. Yeah. The devil is a gentleman.
Wow.
He only goes where
he's invited.
He's invited. Hallelujah. The devil looks for legal doors. If you're full of God, he will not even dare. But if you open a door...
He does not crash in.
No. But when you open a legal door, he will take it. And that's what is happening. But also trying to be cool. You are saying your child is twerking. But you as a mother, you're the chief twerker. You should see them holding bonnets.
The headmistress.
Yes, you're the principal. Chairman.
Of twerking.
Yes, you are holding a bonnet. And twerking like nobody's business, even disrespecting the curfew rules. You, as a parent, what do you expect your children to do? Mm. You understand what I'm saying? Mm. Oh, my son is sleeping around. You are the chief guy. Mm. You're like the United Nations. You have a headquarters everywhere. So we have now to start having this. We have to start having this very difficult conversation. Mm. And what am I talking about? The church must talk about it. Government must talk about it. Schools must talk about it. Mm. We have to stop telling people what they want to hear. We now need to start talking about what we need to hear. Otherwise, we are looking at a generation that will be lost. At the right time, these spoiled kids, I mean, at 16, you're shooting a pawn.
Wow.
And that's the one we know. How many others? Now, another 10 years, they'll be 25, 26. We'll expect them to take the mantle of leadership, spirituality, and to drive the economic bus of this country. Honestly, they'll be growing in age, but not in substance. And yet, the space will be theirs. What will happen? Then that means we risk, as a country, losing 10 years because of lack of productivity. So now, where did we go wrong? If you find somebody's kid misbehaving in the estate and you pinch them, who unto you? They will say, Gerald pinched me. And they will come holding their expensive phones and their Brazilian weaves.